in coming days handle. Now, demography and population issue, which I have discussed in this, in coming days, the important challenge for Indian economy is how to create employment. Employment is going to be the important subject. It is not long-term employment and short-term starvation. No solution. It is not going to be, reforms with human face, this and, reforms with human soul. And your policy is judged every day. It is not that after 5 years we will judge. After 9 years you will be judged. No. Because the democracy in India is very vibrant. No political party and leader can afford to keep aloof himself from these political victories and losses. If you want to remain in power, you have to every day win. Today, this is the situation in this country. We will not know what will happen afterwards, but the present government has initiated a discussion now that there should be elections once in 5 years. All parliament, panchayat, every election one time. So 5 years there should not be anything. Now that is at the discussion level. How much common ground that issue will be able to generate among political parties, I do not know. But today the reality is every day elections are there. This state or that state, or that state or this state. Then that will have a consequences. You know, if you are not able to win in a particular state, it is not one state you have lost. In media, and it is a vibrant democracy. Consolidations and opposition working, all these things will work out in a different way. Whether this government, my government or another government, any government. So, this is a vibrant democracy. In this, you need to have this employment check every year. If you are not able to do, it is not going to be possible. Then, if you do not have the growth along with employment, I call a development model which is suitable for India, it should be a bipodal development model. Bipodal means one is a growth as such, growth per se. Because unless you have a growth over a period of time, the elimination of poverty is not very easy. And the government's ability to provide subsidies and the government's ability to support the disadvantaged sections and disadvantaged people, handicapped people, old age people, and the concept of welfare state will become questionable. So this is a very important thing. So growth per se is also important. Along with growth, the inclusion of growth means developmental process. For every section, employment is the only aspect which ensures all this inclusion. Otherwise, it becomes a welfare, charity. So charity for certain sections is okay, is possible in the longer run, but charity for the entire population is not possible. So employment is the very important aspect. So a development, bipodal development model is very important. This is a very important challenge for any government or policy maker or any leader. Now, another important challenge which this country will be facing is infrastructure. Infrastructure has got employment aspects and all other things, but infrastructure, this country with this kind of 125 crore population, and you are participating at the global level, and you are aspiring to have certain opportunities which are available at the global level, and certain responsibilities you want to entertain, you want to manage at the global level. For that, you need to create a different kind of infrastructure. Not just a kind of narrow vision infrastructure. I am not talking about a comprehensive infrastructure. India connected with Southeast Asia. India able to scale, create a high altitude roads in the Himalayas. India is able to create a lot of road infrastructure and transport communication with the complete Middle East. A different kind of country. Otherwise, you cannot compete with the neighboring countries. Otherwise, you cannot face the neighboring countries. I am not going in detail. So these are the things. So that kind of infrastructure, and that kind of infrastructure means another dimension I would like to mention. Indian investments are growing and will grow. Indian investments, not just in India, Indian investments will grow in other countries. Indian installations will grow in other countries. So our security infrastructure also will be different. The security infrastructure of 2016 is no match to protect the Indian investments and promote and keep safe our investments abroad. Our energy investments, our other investments. So this kind of scenario we will be facing in the next 10 to 15 years. So government has to handle these things. So here it is not just a defensive approach. Offensive approach. Do you mean what? Not just having the inside needs we should fulfill. So with this, one is uniqueness and advantage side, and another is the second this. Now I would like to mention, in coming days we will have a vibrant, very active, very expanding capital markets. But I would like to caution here. The capital markets in India will not be same as the capital markets in America or England. The size of the capital market to the nation's economy will be always less in India. I am making a very important point. You know, previous government leaders were also talking, and sometimes even people now also may be making a statement that when in the capital markets in the last few years, when you have the 14% compound growth, why people should go to the banks? In the banks, when you make deposit, the interest rate is coming down and it is half of that. But people in India, even after that, making deposits in banks, and they are not going to capital markets. In coming, after 10 years also, 50 years also, you will have the similar kind of situation. There may be some kind of difference, change. People going to capital markets, in number, they may increase. But the overall size of deposits, this Indian banks will be the main vehicles of Indian capital in India. Whether I like or not, I am not saying it is good or bad. I am not saying that it should be supported. You know, even if you are reducing the interest rate, people are only... And this is I have seen, this has been in Japan, this has been in Germany. It doesn't mean that we are following Japan or we are following Germany. There are similar kind of countries we have, as we have today here. So Indian banks and Indian bank deposits and Indian system of keeping the savings, it will remain as one of the important feature. So this keeping this in view and the challenges in view. Now I come to another two important points as a part of introduction I would like to make. As I told, employment is very important. Then which is the area in coming years which can create this kind of employment required to meet the needs of the aspirations of the people to the matching level? Unless in coming days we are going to focus on the manufacturing sector, the employment is not going to get generated. So rightly, Honorable Prime Minister has taken this as a very important thing. I understand. At the global level, global growth is coming down. It's a downsize. And in coming years, in the coming next 3 years, I don't think it is going to change. Maybe after 4 years or 5 years, the situation may change. But after that, again, there will be another problem that Euro-American world, their capacity to spend and their capacity to consume, how far they will be able to do the way they had been doing, maybe, I don't know. So the paradigm which was there at the global level as a prescription for every economy, this export growth model. For India, export growth model is not available and is not a solution. I am not saying that exports we should not go for. I am not saying that we will not have exports. But what I am saying is, the size of the country India we have today, for this size, the kind of exports which are needed to create export-led growth model. And the entire growth is generated by exports. It is not possible. But the positive thing for us is, the kind of domestic market India has got, in the world, nowhere you have this kind of domestic market. So manufacturing sector, when I say, it is not like China, which has generated for the whole world. That story is not possible now. But for India, dependence on the outside sources for the domestic needs, it should be drastically reduced. Even you take it as today, defense needs. India is the largest importer. There is a dispute that Saudi Arabia also started importing more than India. But India is the, more than China we are importing. And the kind of security needs we have today and after 20 years we will have, the kind of imports we need, if we do not produce here, then there is no explanation for us. So for entrepreneurs, for employment, and for domestic savers, the defense is going to be the very important area in coming years. It is a lever of growth. And second, the kind of electronic market we have today, and the kind of imports we are getting from outside, definitely there should be an internal substitute for this electronic imports. And if we cannot create companies here to supply this need, then how can they become the global companies? You have not become the domestic companies, so how you can become the global providers? So this is another area which, I am not talking about petroleum products, whether you have any alternative for it or not, but these are the two important areas where the manufacturing sector, apart from the automobile sector, apart from the pharmaceutical sector, apart from all other important sectors, these are going to be the very important areas of manufacturing. This Make in India project, initiated by Narendra Modi ji, will definitely create a kind of revolution in these areas. So manufacturing sector is going to be the very important area. Now, when you address these things, then definitely the trade deficit issue also will be very easily addressed. So, in coming days, in my view, the BJP party, as a political party, this party is different from all other political parties. Not because I am an insider, I am making a point. How it is different, I would like to explain. This is a political party which is, for the last 50, 60 years, comparatively, an ideologically driven political party. And this is a political party where ideologically trained persons become the core leaders. you know, you people have to understand these important things when you handle or when you analyze the political spectrum, you have to make it. So the core leadership of BJP will never come from, you know, a professional politics. A core BJP leader will always come from a trained background, whether it is at the center level or the state level. So there is a, you know, you can watch a person, you can also have a predictability, you can understand. You can, you know, the person will not come from nowhere. And a person also will not come from a particular family, but he has taken birth in that family, so he will become a leader. So you understand that person, then you will understand the politics also. That will not be there. So a different type of political party this is. Second, you know, I don't say all other political parties are non-nationalistic. I don't say. No party can, no leader can be a non-nationalistic. But